For millions of years, the fastest animal on the planet, the cheetah, has had the antelope in its sights. But evolution has given the antelope an arsenal of countermeasures, so it has a chance to escape. In order to survive, this cheetah has had to develop more weapons than just her speed. It's the ultimate battle of biomechanics, as science determines who wins one of nature's deadliest face-offs, seen through the eyes of iPredator. The cheetah and the antelopes are well matched in the predator-prey struggle. Because as fast as the cheetah is, with her blazing top speed of 120 kilometers per hour, some members of the antelope family, which includes gazelles and impalas, are nearly as fast, hitting over 95 kilometers per hour. But speed alone didn't win this mother cheetah a much-needed meal. It's her incredible burst of acceleration that makes her one of the most successful predators in Africa, catching half the animals she hunts. She exploded with a lightning-quick jolt from 0 to 95 kilometers per hour in less than 3 seconds. That's an acceleration faster than a jet plane. The secret to her explosive stride is her perfectly engineered spine. About 60% of her muscle mass is packed onto her backbone. Her spine expands and contracts with so much force it actually adds 3/4 of a meter to her stride, giving her the power to lunge nearly 8 meters in a single bound. The ground races past her at 31 meters per second, but she stays locked on target. Once her unrivaled burst of acceleration kicks in, the antelope's lead is gone. But this cheetah's job isn't done yet. She's so streamlined for speed, she can't deliver a deadly bite through the antelope's spine like a lion does. Her aerodynamic skull doesn't leave room for strong teeth or jaw muscles.
The only way that the cheetah can make a kill is by going to the throat and making a strangulation hold.
She squeezes the antelope's throat. She holds this throat lock for nearly 10 minutes. And while she's decreasing the antelope's oxygen supply, she's actually increasing hers, sucking in deep breaths through her enlarged nasal cavity, trying to recover from the massive strain of a 120 kilometers per hour sprint. But she can't afford to rest any longer.
The animal could weigh as much as she does, but she needs to get it out of there. She can't eat it in the open. She has to get that food to a safe place and eat it as quick as possible before it attracts the attention of some of the other predators.
With just her teeth, she drags the 30-kilogram carcass under the cover of a tree.
She has to slow down for just a little bit and catch her breath again. She has to rest anywhere from 15 minutes to half an hour to fully get down to a normal heart rate.
Running faster than any land animal on Earth takes a massive toll on her body. She just burned through 300 calories in one chase. That's like a human running without stopping for over 30 minutes. She did it in 30 seconds. Most cheetahs would spend the next half hour resting and then eating. But this mother cheetah doesn't have that luxury. She has to get this meal to her four cubs. But the African savanna is full of other hungry predators. Just as she approaches her cubs, a lion is on to her. And if she can't keep him away, she'll lose today's meal. Any injury to her would mean death for her starving cubs. So she has no choice but to hand over the kill. All of that effort, that loss of precious energy, gone in the blink of an eye.
50% of the kills that she makes are stolen by larger predators. A cheetah is not equipped to fight. Cheetah just doesn't stand a chance.
Losing that antelope was a big blow for the cheetah. She burns at least 2,500 calories a day, and this substantial meal, almost 5,000 calories, would have given her enough energy to keep her going for two more days. And now, her energy level is dropping. Her survival hinges upon consuming more calories than she burns. Once she hits zero, she's in the danger zone and starts burning her own muscle for fuel. The cheetah's back with her cubs, but since female cheetahs are always single mothers, she'll have to once again leave her cubs alone to embark on another hunt. In the distance, she spots what humans could never see with the naked eye.
It'd be very similar to us grabbing a pair of high-powered binoculars. And as you're scanning the landscape, something that will catch your eye is the same thing that'll catch her eyes, and that's movement.
Closes in on potential prey, but she can't make her move too quickly. Because when two of the fastest animals in Africa engage in a battle, the difference between life and death isn't just speed, it's also vision. This cheetah, like most predators, has evolved with eyes on the front of her skull. It gives her binocular vision and the depth perception to calculate exactly how far away her prey is. As important as eyesight is for the cheetah, it's even more important for the antelope. Antelopes, like most prey, have eyes on the sides of their skull. So while a cheetah may have a field of vision of over 200 degrees, The eyes on the sides of the antelope's head give him a 270-degree field of view. With a tiny shift of his neck, he monitors the full 360 degrees of his environment. His eyes are so sensitive to movement, he can detect the slightest motion of a predator. Now in the antelope's line of sight, the cheetah freezes. She knows if she remains motionless, she is virtually invisible.
The tawny color of the cheetah does a great job of blending her into her environment. Those spots that are covering her body look very much like shadows and help to break up her pattern, so it's very difficult for some of the other animals to see.
What she's doing is kind of digging her feet in, and she's getting ready for that push-off. It's like a track runner getting into the blocks before the gun blows.
In this eons-old battle of life and death, the cheetah has always had the advantage of speed. But it comes with a catch. She has almost no endurance. And on this hunt, without a strong head start, she got caught up in a long chase, redlining her body's powerful engine. She takes 150 breaths a minute, three times as many as the fastest human sprinter. Her massive heart pumps over 16 liters of blood per minute, circulating her entire body's blood supply in less than 20 seconds. At this pace, she has less than half a minute before her body gives in to the stress. Her heart blasts 39-degree blood into her brain, another 1.5 degrees higher, and it overheats. She only has seconds to make this kill, or the chase could kill her.
Once the body starts to go into overdrive and overheat, the brain is the most vulnerable of all of our body parts. Once the brain overheats, there's almost no bringing it back.
But the antelope is in less danger of overheating because he has a built-in cooling system. Before blood reaches his brain, it passes through a cluster of blood vessels that are cooled by rapid bursts of air shooting through his enlarged nasal cavity. Just like a car's radiator, it prevents vital fluids from overheating. And even as his body temperature reaches a scorching 42 degrees, his brain is protected, and he can stay cooler under pressure. When the cheetah's temperature hit 40 degrees, her body told her she had mere seconds to decide whether to let the antelope get away or die trying to catch it.
For a cheetah, if they start their hunt too early, they can burn themselves out very quickly and not be able to catch their prey.
She gave it everything she had, but the hunt ended in disaster.
An antelope can run close to 50 miles an hour. You're thinking, okay, well, a cheetah can run faster than that, but the antelope can maintain that speed for a very, very long time. They're more like endurance runners that can run very, very fast, whereas the cheetahs are just sprinters.
Not only did she fail to come away with a meal, her energy reserves took a huge hit. And on her next couple hunts, it gets worse. First, she springs after a lone male and closes in a hurry. But what seems like an easy target suddenly becomes a tough kill. Instead of running away, the antelope bounces up and down. It's a countermeasure called stotting, a last-ditch effort to intimidate the cheetah by projecting strength and stamina. And it works. Her initial sprint has already taken a lot out of her, and she can't afford to burn any more energy on a kill she's not certain she can make. It gets even more challenging on her next hunt, as she creeps to within 45 meters of a herd of antelope. But they sprint away, bursting into gravity-defying leaps. Shooting 3 meters into the air, in and out of the cheetah's line of sight, is too disorienting. And she gives up the chase. But not without depleting her energy reserves even further. It's been a rough couple of days for her. She and her cubs have gone without any food, and things are starting to look desperate.
Physically, the cheetah can probably last about as long as you or I could last without food. Probably 5 or 6 days without eating before she absolutely collapses of starvation.
She's constantly looking for predators that could come after her cubs. She's looking for prey that she could be hunting, which means that she doesn't have a lot of downtime. She's always on. That adrenaline that's within them constantly is keeping them on guard. It's like being at war, where you're never able to relax.
She has to find food, and find it fast. She approaches her next hunt like a covert operation, targeting a herd with several juveniles, who are slower and less alert.
The closer that she can get to him before she actually starts running, the higher the likelihood that she's going to catch it down. And it takes far less energy to crouch and sneak up on the animal than it does the full-out run.
As she closes to within a few hundred meters, she initiates her stealth mode. Suddenly, the body known for moving faster than any on four legs moves extremely slowly. She stalks her prey for nearly an hour when a youngster finally strays from the group. He's incredibly vulnerable, but still over 90 meters beyond her striking range. If she attacks now, she risks burning out and losing her prey in a long chase. But if she doesn't make a move soon, this perfect target could fall back in with his herd, and her best shot at a meal would disappear. It's a risk she has to take. Against the odds, this cheetah came away with a kill. And she did it with an explosive burst from 0 to 95 kilometers in just 3 seconds. At that speed, she should have blurred and distorted vision, which would make it nearly impossible for her to accurately lock in her target. But in an amazing feat of biomechanical engineering, she has an elastic ligament connecting her head directly to her spine. It gives her optical image stabilization, which means that even at breakneck speed, her neck and head are perfectly steady, moving directly forward, straight as an arrow, providing the pinpoint accuracy she needs to track her prey and make a quick, clean kill.
After she's made the kill, she'll chew open the hindquarters, which has the largest amount of meat. The cubs don't have strong enough teeth to do that. Then the cubs will come in and start eating first.
By the time her cubs have eaten, there are just a few bites left for her. She's picked up a small amount of energy, but her tank is still close to empty. Despite being exhausted, she'll have to start all over again.
If she doesn't hunt, that means she could starve, and if she starves, then the cubs starve. It's a very, very hard life for a female cheetah.
Her cubs are completely dependent on her, and she now knows that while hunting small antelope might keep her cubs alive, they won't keep her alive for long. She locks in on a large antelope, alone and oblivious. For over an hour, she stalks him to within 45 meters, close enough to strike. He's huge, weighing 60 kilograms. He'd be more than enough food for her family. But does she have enough energy left in her tank to catch him and bring him down? To knock her giant adversary right off its feet. Because at the exact moment the antelope's leg is on its backswing, she extends her paw and lashes out with her greatest weapon in a high-speed pursuit, her dewclaw. Because it doesn't touch the ground when she runs, this is her only claw that stays razor sharp. It latches onto the antelope's hip. He runs at nearly 80 kilometers per hour, trying to pull free from the cheetah's grip. But her dewclaw is hooked so deeply into the antelope's thick hide that she can't be shaken. With just this tiny claw, 2.5 centimeters long, she sends a 60 kilogram antelope tumbling to the ground. In one lethal swipe, she's able to get the antelope down. But with his enormous size, she can't keep him down. what she thought was a kill may actually kill her. This cheetah's dew claw helped her take this giant antelope down, but her other claws actually prevented her from keeping him down. They're too dull to tear the antelope's skin. And her teeth and jaw don't have the strength to land a strong bite. Lacking weapons in this biomechanical arms race, she tries one last desperate move, going for a kill bite.
Antelope have weapons that point straight up. So in the act of tumbling around, the cheetah's got to negotiate where she can get in safely and get a nice bite on the neck. If she doesn't negotiate that right, she's not in good shape.
She's lucky to have escaped without being gored, burning far more calories than she's consuming. Is pushing her body to the brink and risking the very survival of her family. After catching her breath, she heads back to the tree under which she last left her cubs. They're gone. Their scent is out of her range. Her only hope is to call out to them. But if she alerts any predators to her cubs' presence, it would put them in grave danger.
From the time that cubs are very, very little, they know that they need to fear lions and they need to fear hyenas. They kill cheetah cubs, not because they like the taste of the cheetah. In fact, a lot of the times, whenever they do kill a cub, they don't even eat it. But what they are doing is eliminating the competition that's in the area.
With so many ruthless competitors around, she needs to track down her cubs without exposing them.
When she gets separated from her cubs, she's going to start to chirp like a bird. Large predators are very used to the roaring sounds and the very typical cat sounds. She emits this sound that sounds like a bird, and all of a sudden, hyena's not paying attention anymore because, oh, it's just a bird.
She's done what she had to do. But how did she manage to hold off a hyena that's bigger, stronger, and a flat-out better fighter? She was helped by the long black tear lines under her eyes.
Cheetahs are the only cat species who have tear lines that go all the way from the corners of their eyes down to the corner of their mouth. Those tear lines exacerbate her facial expressions. Native Americans used to wear war paint to make themselves seem much more physically intimidating. So if she snarls and hisses and spits and those tear lines make her look more aggressive, maybe she can get away.
Her cubs are safe for now, but predators like hyenas, lions, and leopards pose a serious threat every time she leaves them alone.
About 10% of the cubs will make it to their year old. That first year of their life is the most difficult time because literally everything is looking out for them and will take advantage of a cheetah cub being left alone.
So this mother is forced to make a difficult choice. Does she go off on a hunt to provide for her cubs? Or does she stay close to protect them from perpetual danger? Right now, she decides her cubs need food more than they need her protection. Over the past week, this mother cheetah has struggled with the increased hunting demands of having four growing cubs, burning far more energy than she's consuming. And now her caloric reserves have dropped below zero. She's burning through fat and even muscle just to keep her going. If she doesn't succeed in this next hunt, it could be her last. She shifts her tactics. Rather than hunt at dawn or dusk, when there's greater competition, she decides to go on the prowl at midday, when predator traffic dies down. This is also when the sun is at its brightest, which is a big problem for most of Africa's predators. But the cheetah is equipped to handle the glare. The very same tear lines that helped her and her cubs escape the hyena may enhance her vision in the harshest African sunlight.
When human athletes are out in the middle of the day playing football or baseball, they wear black grease under their eyes to help dampen the glare of the sunlight. Cheetahs do the same thing, so that when she's hunting, that sunlight doesn't affect her so much.
Fully equipped to handle the blazing sun, she creeps up on a herd of antelope, but doesn't move in from behind. She goes the long way, taking a position to its side. Why would she risk moving into the antelope's line of sight? To avoid the wind.
The antelope's sense of smell is amazing. Over time, a cheetah will learn that it could give away its presence just by its scent. So it'll start learning to approach the animal downwind.
Her focus shifts to two antelopes straying from the herd. She creeps as close as she can, hoping to avoid burning what little energy she has left in a long-distance chase. Start to separate. And in an instant, she has to make a choice. This one is over 35 meters away. The other is much closer. But her brain instantly registers four obstacles surrounding it. Each represents a chance for her prey to escape. Each of these obstacles can prevent her from reaching top speed. Each of these obstacles can cost her 2 to 3 strides. And without her blazing top speed, her greatest advantage slips away. This one might be farther away and bigger, but she has a cleaner path, a straighter trajectory of attack. She's analyzed dozens of variables and made her choice. She knows she has just enough energy for one final sprint. A sprint which won't exceed 30 seconds. If she has chosen the wrong antelope, she may reach the limit of her endurance, and she and her cubs will starve. Just 10 seconds into the chase, the cheetahs close the gap on the antelope to 15 meters. At this pace, her speed advantage would put her on the antelope's back in just 2.2 seconds. But suddenly, the antelope begins darting side to side. Each sharp turn by the antelope forces the cheetah to alter her path, adding 2 seconds to the chase. If he makes 10 of these quick turns, he'll push the cheetah to the limit of her endurance. The antelope may be slower, but evolution gave him a potential lifesaver. Agility. At risk of starvation, this mother cheetah finally made the big kill she needed to keep herself alive. There's more than enough food here to recharge her energy and provide for her cubs. So how was she able to match the quickness and agility of the antelope? To keep her body under such precise control at such intense speed, she relied on two key body parts. First, her claws. Unlike most other cats, they never fully retract. They're like a sprinter's track spikes, giving her constant traction and the sharpest turning radius of all of Africa's big cats. So even at this breakneck speed, she turns on a dime. And as vital to her agility as her claws is her 76-centimeter long tail.
A cheetah's tail is very, very long and very muscular. And as she is running at top speed, she'll use that the way a boat would use a rudder. So as she's turning, she'll throw the tail out to one side to help her corner one way, to throw it out to the other side to help her corner in the other direction.
Her claws and tail gave her the agility and balance to go stride for stride with the antelope. And with a bigger stride than the antelope, she gained enough ground to finally take it down. It was the perfect kill. Executed with a perfect combination of predatory skills. A silent stalk of unsuspecting prey. A burst of acceleration. A split-second decision. A surge of quickness. And a perfectly timed swipe of her dew claw. All led to the most important kill of her life. Exhausted, she tries to recover from the fight. But out here on the open plain, she's a prime target for a mugging. Will she continue to rest and risk losing her kill to a hungry adversary? Or can she summon up the strength to drag the 45-kilogram carcass back to her cubs before a predator tries to snatch it from her?
She's got to manage to slow her heart rate, slow her respiration rate, and then she can actually think about being able to bring an antelope back to feed her cubs.
But despite having this fresh kill in her teeth, she's only fought half the battle. She still has to drag the heavy carcass to her cubs and do it without drawing any attention. She returns to her cubs undetected, still exhausted from the hunt. She barely has the energy to dig in for the caloric boost she so desperately needs. But she still can't let down her guard. Other opportunists are swooping in. Over 40 vultures descend on the cheetah and make it clear they will challenge her for the kill.
If a cheetah gets tangled up with a big bird like a vulture and just gets a wound, a nicked forelimb, then that cheetah's as good as dead, because that animal can then no longer run 70 miles an hour.
She tries to bluff, but still weak from the chase, she's all bark and no bite. And the vultures can sense it. This is nature's way of leveling the predatory playing field. The cheetah is the fastest animal on four legs, one of the best hunters in Africa. But it comes with a great genetic sacrifice.
The cheetahs are almost over-specialized. Because every adaptation that these cats have that gives them so much greater speed comes at a cost, there's no middle ground.
Her small, slender head boosts aerodynamics for maximum speed, but translate into weak jaws and small teeth. Her semi-retractable claws provide incredible traction and agility, but they're anything but deadly weapons. And her lightweight skeleton keeps the cheetah quick and agile. But small bones mean less mass, and she's often outweighed by other predators and even prey. This cheetah and her cubs weren't able to finish their meal, but they've eaten enough to make it through another day. It's all part of their constant struggle just to survive.
The larger carnivores like lions and hyenas have been able to grow their populations, which have outcompeted the cheetahs. In the last 100 years, we've lost about 90% of the cheetahs that are left in the world.
For this cheetah's part, all she can do is continue to provide for her cubs, protect them from danger, and teach them her predatory strategies, in hopes that they will one day survive on their own. Fortunately for her, they already possess their deadliest hunting weapon, a genetic gift given to them at birth, pure, unadulterated speed.